Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to this series, Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at quantizing pitches. In recent videos, we've been looking at sequencing pitches, creating a sequencer in Pure Data. One thing which is often useful for working in conjunction with those sequences is being able to quantize the pitches to a particular scale or mode. So in this tutorial, we're going to start by looking at quantizing to a C major scale, which is all of the white notes on a keyboard between one C and the next, or in fact any white note really. What's makes this a little bit complicated is that the intervals between these pitches in the scale are not symmetrical. You'll see this diagram shows that between C and D there are two steps, two either called half steps or semitones. Then there's two between D and E, but there's only one between E and F, then two between F and G, two between G and A, two between A and B, and one between B and C. So because there's a mixture of twos and ones, we can't do an easy formula for that, and because there's two twos then a one and three twos then a one, it's not symmetrical in that way either. So this is the challenge that we're going to be looking at today. What we want to do is to make sure that when notes are generated by our sequencer, that any notes that are not in the scale, in this particular case any of the black notes, are quantized, that is they're shifted down to be one of the white notes, to be a scalic note. All right, let's get started. The trick to this is going to be the select function. What we're going to do is to select notes which are within the scale. We can do this by using numbers, numbering the indexes of the scale, the scale degrees, numbering them between 0 and 11. 0 in this case representing C, 2 representing D, 4 is E, 5 is F, 7 is G, 9 is A, and 11 is B. So if it's one of these scalic degrees, it's going to come out one of the first series of outlets. And the way the select works is if it's not any of those, that is if it's not a scale degree, it's going to come out the last outlet. And that's what's going to be useful for us. So if we have a number as input, just use a number box, we can send numbers to it. For the moment, I'm just going to limit that between 0 and 127, so it's going to be MIDI pitches. Then we can see whether or not this is a scale degree or not. If it's not a scale degree, the number will come out here. Actually, if it's not 0 or to 11, my mistake, then the numbers will come out here. So any large number will, of course, but when we get to small numbers, you'll see that only numbers that are not in there, 3 and 6 and 8 and so forth, are coming out. In order to make sure that we resolve this down simply to this octave, we're going to use the mod function. If we mod by 12, then any number that comes in, we only get the remainder of 12. We know that there's 12 semitones in a chromatic octave, and so that will, because that then we can go above 12. It will always resolve it down to a number between 0 and 11, and we can see here that numbers which are not in the scale are displayed. So how does this help us? Once we've identified notes which are within the scale or not within the scale, we can treat them differently. What we're going to do is we're going to subtract one from any pitch which is not in the scale, and that will resolve it down to being within the scale. So you'll notice that this is actually a message box that I've created here, so it's not like a math function or anything. We're going to send the negative one to a plus object over here. So we're going to take the original pitch value and we're going to subtract one from it. And that will provide us with a scale degree pitch coming out. We also need, if it is a scale degree, to override the negative one. We don't want it to be always negative one. We want, in some cases, for it to be zero. So plus zero is just the original pitch. And if it's any of the scale degrees, then that's what we want. Otherwise, it will have one subtracted from it. So for example, if it's 5, it will just go to 0 and nothing will change from the number we generate. If it's 6, however, it will come out the final outlet. Negative 1 will go to plus and 6 will be resolved, quantized in fact, to 5. So as we move through, it's probably easier to see if we go right down to the bottom. We scale through, we get a 3. 3 does not appear down here. 3 comes out here. We go minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2, and so forth and so on. So that's how that works. So it's probably useful if we can hear this too. So let's very quickly create a process to do that. If we get a MIDI to frequency object that will convert it into frequencies, we can pass those frequencies to an oscillator. We want that oscillator to have a volume control. And then that will go out to a DAC. I'll create a volume slider for us here, change the properties of that to go between 0 and 1. And that can go in here. And let's see how we go if we turn the volume up a little. Very low. So once we get up into a range, and you can hear that that's quantizing to just pitches which are in the major scale. To make that a bit more like a sequencer, we're not going to build an entire sequencer in this video. You can see the other videos for that. What we can do though is just use metronome set to 250 millisecond intervals and have that randomly generate frequencies, let's say over 2 octaves and a bit. And if we offset that into a pitch range which is going to be a bit more sensible, turn the volume up. So there you can hear that we've got random pitches across 2 octaves and they're all being quantized so that we only hear notes of the major scale. So that could be it, but it's not entirely it because the major scale is kind of okay and so are most of the other church modes in the sense that the largest interval is 2 half steps or 2 semitones, and so we just need to offset anything by 1 and we shift it down. But there are some scales where there is a larger interval than that, say 3 half steps, and so minusing 1 will not be sufficient. In some cases we'll need to move some of those pitches down 2 half steps or 2 semitones in order to resolve back to a scale tone. So let's have a look at how to do that. We're basically going to repeat the process a second time to deal with those additional cases. So if I change this scale to a major pentatonic, then this particular scale will have a large interval. You can see that the distance between the fourth degree and the fourth number and 7 is actually 3 semitones, and so an offset of just 1 will not be sufficient to do that. So what we need to do is to basically repeat the process of filtering using select. We put the scale, same scale, in again, and we double check in a sense to make sure that even by taking one off, that may not have been enough, and it's possible that we will still get numbers out here, as you can see, which we do. Let's see, let's make that a minus one, as in actually doing the math. So takes off one, then double checks, and the numbers are coming out here, pitches which don't adequately resolve just with one semitone taken off them. So because of that, it means that in this case, these particular pitches need they need actually two semitones taken off them, the pitches which is there. So whatever generated this number actually needs two taken off it. And all of these other ones, which were fine after they had one semitone taken off them, one half step taken off them, they just need to have a one half step reduction. So we can pass that to our plus function, and also that to our plus function. Oh, I see, my mistake. I made an error there by putting a space, and so it was minus space 2, where it should have just been minus 2, and that's why these errors were being generated. My apologies for that. So if it's fine in the first instance, it is in the scale, nothing needs to be done to it. If it's not in the scale, then we subtract 1 to it and we double check. If the subtracting of 1 was sufficient to put it within the scale, then we just subtract that 1. If the subtracting one was not sufficient, then we subtract 2. So let's have a listen. And you can hear that, just like a nice pentatonic scale, we're getting no inharmonic kind of pitches. They're all nicely held within the scale. If you want to do some other scale, you need to change the scale to numbers that are here in the select boxes, remembering that they represent semitone or half step chromatic positions within the octave. So 0 is C, 2 is D, 4 is E, 7 is G, 9 is A, and so on and so forth. So it's possible then for us, if we wanted to put this into our sequencing process, that we could just grab all of that and simply make a subpatch, in this case maybe called quant, and we can paste all of that in there. And then let's deal with this subpatch. I'm just going to cover that up for a little bit. We need, of course, in our subpatch to add an inlet and add an outlet, so we can get the values in and out. And so now when we put that in, turn the volume up, so our quantizing function is happening inside, neatly inside a subpatch, and this can be inserted into sequences or any other patches where you need to quantize pitches to a particular scale. See you in another video.